Hello everyone, thanks for joining me in the Allan Block workshop to learn about what it takes to successfully construct your Allan Block retaining wall project. What I will walk you through today is the site preparation and excavation steps for proper retaining wall construction. This will be done once you've checked out your materials and have all the equipment on site. Now let's grab our tools and head out to our sandbox. How you start your project will simplify your work. If you would like additional help, please refer to our installation guides found on our website. To start your layout, place a stake to represent the location of the front of the wall. Then, using stakes, a string liner paint, mark out the entire length of the wall. A garden hose is an excellent tool to use when laying out curved walls. Once the layout is complete, excavate the area by removing all surface vegetation and organic soils and set aside for finishing your project. For reinforced walls, you will need to excavate the soil behind the wall to accommodate the design length of the reinforced grid as well as the soil in front of the wall location. Set it aside for later use. Refer to your approved plans for exact grid lengths to determine the depth of the excavated area. Start digging the base trench at the lowest elevation specified on the approved plans. The minimum width for a base trench is 24 inches. The depth of the trench is determined by allowing for 6 inches of base material plus 1 inch per foot of wall height. Again, follow the recommendations of your approved plans for all walls over 4 feet and on all commercial walls. If organic, clay, or wet soils are still present in the base trench area or under the infill soil, they must be removed and replaced with a granular material as it may become problematic to the performance of the wall. The base trench must now be compacted. Using a mechanical plate compactor, make a minimum of 2 passes in the trench. You do not want settlement after the wall is built to occur, so ensure the base is properly compacted. Now, check for level. Run a string line at the height of the grade for a measuring point. Then using a tape measure, check if the trench is at the proper depth at multiple points of the trench. Then using a 4-foot level, check the bottom of the trench. Screening and adjusting is needed. A laser level can also be used to check the entire project. When a drain pipe is required, install it at the lowest possible point toward the back of the trench that will be vented to daylight every 50 feet. That could be below the wall or through the block face. It is typically needed for anything over 4 feet tall or reinforced walls. See our installation guides for more details or alternative drain pipe placement. Now, with the base trench level and the drain pipe in, place a minimum of 6 inches of wall rock in the base trench and rake smooth. Once the wall rock is in place, compact the base again. Using a mechanical plate compactor, make a minimum of 2 passes to compact the wall rock to form the compacted base. Using the string line again and a tape measure, check the base for level at multiple points along the length of the wall. Using a 4-foot level, check for any high spots, screening the wall rock as necessary to adjust the base. A laser level can also be used to check the entire project. A straight and level base will make installing the first course much easier. So let's review what we have covered for site preparation and excavation. You want to lay out and locate your retaining wall using a string line paint or even a garden hose. You will then need to excavate the entire area to accommodate your base rock, block, wall rock, and if needed, geogrid. It is important to make sure all organic materials have been removed. For your base trench, you will dig a trench that has a minimum width of 24 inches, and the depth of the trench will start at 6 inches, plus 1 inch per foot of wall height to account for the buried block. Then, compact the bottom of the trench before installing your drain pipe and 6 inches of wall rock. Once the wall rock has been placed, ensure that it is compacted and level before you start installing your first course of block. There are many reasons why you need to take your time before every project and think about the site preparation. Any soft areas or mistakes encountered in the base will only create problems as you construct your wall. By following this simple process, you will ensure your project gets started in the right direction. For the next steps, go to the base course section or visit us at allanblock.com. Happy building! Always better! Always Allan Block!